Okay, good morning to my lecture on machine learning. Yesterday I have talked about iris flowers data. We have worked on support vector machine with the help of two features, sepal length and sepal width. And yesterday we have developed the model. Yesterday we have developed the separate equation of a separating line. So I will share it with you. So today I will talk on illustrations of SVM. See, yesterday we are here. We have obtained the weights and we have combined the weights with support vectors and we have obtained the final weights W1, W2 and B. With the help of this, we have developed the model that is 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5 equal to 0. That's the equation of your true separating line. 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 sepal width minus 3.5 equal to 1 is your marginal line on right side. Marginal line on right side. I will show you here. See, this is the marginal line on right side. So we have equation. 7 times sepal length. 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5 equal to plus 1. Now if your point is 1 plus 1 or greater than plus 1, you are to this region. And when you are to this region, that means you are on other class of flowers. Another line is 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5 equal to minus 1. So this line is here on the left side of your true separating line. So if 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5 is less than minus 1, you are to this side. That means you have a one category of flowers. So that is how we are separating flowers from each other based on sepal length and sepal width. All right? Okay. Now, see friends, once we develop the model, we must be able to evaluate that model. How far the model is good? How far the model is true enough in classifying the objects? What is the rate of misclassification? What is the overall accuracy of the model? So these are the different questions that we have to answer when we are working with any model of classification. Now for that purpose, we have to do something. What we have to do something, that I will share now. I will share you that now. Okay, see, this is iris flower file. See, this is iris flower file. We have here the data. Now we'll forget about this data. Now see here, this is the model, and on the basis of for each flower, we have to use sepal length and sepal width, and we have to do these calculations. And based on this calculation, we have to declare the class. So for all 150 flowers, we have to do these calculations, right? And we have to declare them a class minus one or class plus one. So what I will do is, I will go to the what is called as Minitab model, and in Minitab, I will try to see how to work with this. So let us see, this is the Minitab. Now in this Minitab, I will show you. See, this is the sepal length, this is the sepal width. This is the sepal length, this is the sepal width. And remember that objects on left side are of one kind, those are 15 number. Objects on right side are of other type, those are 100 in number. Those are mixed with two flowers. So we have to make their classification on the basis of actual given classes. So here I have done it as minus one to the left side, one to the right side, minus one to the left side, one to the right side, like this. So this classification, it is called as a coding. So we have to do this kind of coding. And now we have to make this combination that 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5. This calculation we have to do. And now I will tell you how to do this calculation here. Actually, I have already done it, but I will show you how to do this in Minitab. Because in all such algebra, you are supposed to be expert in operating various types of software simultaneously. So let us see how I will do. I will come to the value class. I will come to the calculation. That means I will come to the calculator and see in the calculator how I will do it. I have a value class here. I have a value class here. So I will make calculation and I will put this calculation in the column of value. Now, what is the expression I am using for calculation? My expression is what? 5 times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5. So see, this is my 5. This is my 5, right? Then times sepal length minus 7.5 times sepal width minus 3.5. This is my expression. This is my mathematical expression. How to combine sepal length and sepal width? So I hope you have understood this. I have been using calculator in Minitab that is available in Calci part. Okay. Now if I see, press OK, you will find that all calculations are completed. In Excel also you can do this, but in Excel you have to drag, you have to copy paste for all remaining cells. Here you will get the entire column get calculated. All right. Now we have to find out the predicted class. Here we have an actual class, we have to find out the predicted class. How I will find? I have to code it. All those values less than minus one, I will declare them as minus one. All those values one or more than one, I will declare them as one. Because values less than minus one will fall in left side, and that is my one class. Values one or more will fall in second class, and I will call it as a one. So let us see how to do this prediction or how to do this coding. So I will come to the data. I will come to the code and see here, there is a different types of codes here. Numeric to numeric coding, numeric to text coding, numeric to date time coding, text to text coding, text to numeric coding, text to date and time coding, data time to date and time coding, date time to numeric coding, date time to text coding, and you have your own way of conversation. I will do numeric to numeric first. So see here, what I have to code, I have to code the values from column C4, that is value. So I will take it here. This newly defined code That means predicted class. I have to put it in C5 class. So I will select it here. Now see, how I will code it. You can see here, what are the original values and what is their new code. So original values means all those values less than -1. So I don't know how much is the less than -1 value. So let me put -300:-1.0000001. So all values less than -1. I will declare it by -1. All values greater than 1.0000001:500. I will declare it by 1. So this is the minimum possible value. This is the maximum possible value. I don't know in the column. So I will take a large value as I can do it. So that it will make the coding of all possible values. If I say okay, see here -1, 1, all these things. All right. And now I want to check whether my actual class and predicted class is same or not. Actual class, predicted class is same or not. If in all cases, actual class and predicted class is same, then you will say that model is good. Or to what extent actual class and predicted class is same? To what extent there is a misclassification? That I have to see. That means what? I can treat actual class as one attribute, predicted class as another attribute, and I will find out a 2x2 contingency table. In Excel, if I go to stat, if I go to tables, if I go to cross tabulation, I can do it. So see, for row wise, I will take actual class. Column wise, I will take predicted class. And I will just say okay here. As soon as I say okay, I got a class classification here. I got a table here. So row wise are actual classes. That means this is the actual left side class, actual right side class, predicted left side class, and predicted right class. So this is 49, 1, 0, 100. Now I will explain you this on PPT. So let us see here. So the same table I have placed here. You can see this same table I have placed here. Same table I have placed here. This is actual class Setosa and other. This is predicted class Setosa and other. These are the totals. So you can see here, what is this number? See here. See this number. See this number. This number is 49. What is it? It is 49 flowers having their actual class as Setosa are predicted in the Setosa class itself. I will repeat again. 49 flowers belonging to Setosa class are predicted as Setosa itself. That means this is the correct classification. If you come here, you will find that one flower is there whose actual class is Setosa. But our support vector machine model classifies it in other class. So it is a kind of a misclassification. Setosa flower is misclassified as non-Setosa flower, other class. So that is a misclassification. If you see here, among the other type of flowers, there is no misclassification. None of the flower is declared by our SVM as setosa. So here, other way around, misclassification is zero. What is the meaning of this 100? This 100 means what? The flowers on other class means to the right side class. All 100 flowers are rightly classified in other class itself. So there is a chance of misclassification. And with the help of this, I will write something which is nothing but model evaluation. Probability of incorrect classification. If you see the total probability of misclassification, these two figures are misclassification. And there is only one misclassification. Out of how many? In fact, out of 150 flowers. Out of 150 flowers, there is only one misclassified. So my probability is what? My probability is 1 upon 150, which is 0.0067. Which means very, very small. What is the probability of misclassifying setosa flower in other class? This is another way of looking towards the model evaluation. What is the probability of misclassifying setosa flower in other class? See, I have setosa flowers, how many? 50 flowers. I have setosa flowers, 50 in number. Right. I have 50 setosa flowers. And out of these 50 flowers, only one is misclassified. And so I will say that probability of misclassification is 1 upon 50 or 0.02. That means 2% chance of misclassifying setosa flower as other flower is there. What is the probability of misclassifying other flower in setosa class? See, in other, there are 100 flowers, and out of this 100 flower, there is none misclassified, and so my probability is zero. If I talk about the overall accuracy, my overall accuracy will be this. My overall accuracy will be this. I will show you. See, this is my overall accuracy. These 49 flowers are rightly classified. These 100 flowers are also rightly classified. And therefore, my correct classification is 49 plus 100 flowers. Means 149 flowers out of how many? 150 flowers. And so overall accuracy of the model is 149 divided by 150, which is 0.9933. That means 99.33% accuracy is there. So model is quite good. 99.73% model is quite good, right? So this is the model evaluation. Now, let us come here. We have taken here among the four features, we have considered only two features. So this is sepal length and sepal width. This is what we have completed with the accuracy of 99.33%. This is what the accuracy we have. Right. Now, see here, what are the other possibilities? Other possibilities are also there. And you can see the other possibilities. You can do different combinations. One combination is here. You can take now instead of sepal length and sepal width, you can take petal length and petal width. Work out the same. Find out the support vectors. Use the support vector, find out the weights. Find out the B bias and find out classification. And lastly, overall accuracy of the model. First one is 99.73. Find out for this also. This is one combination. Another combination is slightly different. Use sepal length and petal width. Use petal width, petal length, and use petal length and petal width, sepal width. Use sepal length and petal length. Use sepal width and petal width. So these are the six combinations. These are the six combinations. Out of these six combinations, we have done this. Now this combination, this combination is a parallel combination to this sepal length and sepal width. Instead of sepal, you are using petal. The other four combinations, you can practice this. But if you see the difference between the first two combinations and last four combinations, there is a one basic difference. And the difference is, in first two combination, you are using a single object, either a sepal or a petal. So you are measuring sepal length and sepal width, or you are measuring petal length or petal width. So that is the single object you are using for the task of classification. Whereas in other four combinations, in other four options, you are using sepal also and petal also. So you are using two objects for the classification. And now we have to see the effect of using one object and using two objects. Whether using two objects is better or whether using one object is better, that we have to do. And so I will suggest you to take this exercise and carry on this. All right. So with this, I will stop my today's lecture. If you have any question, you are free to ask. I will post this video to you. All the three videos I will post you, so you can get the idea. You can get this. If you have any question, you can ask the question. You can unmute and you can ask the question, or you can put your question on chat box. If you have any question, you can ask.